We're ready for you, Your Majesty. 3, 2, 1.
Much of the success of The Crown has been put down to the meticulous research that was done to inform the incredible storylines across the 6 seasons of the show. But that same research went into the costumes, many replicating outfits that were worn by the royals at significant moments in history. And the attention to detail when you see some of these costumes up close is incredible.
In this era, the Queen always wore fairly bright colours because she needs to be seen when she's in a crowd. But she really seemed to go for these wonderful, bold, block colours. She's feeling quite fragile in her life and undermined politically by Blair, who's on the up, and she feels she's on the down. So you feel like she's putting on armour.
Thousands of outfits were recreated for the series, some taking more than 7 weeks to make. And for Emmy-winning costume designer Amy Roberts, it was an endeavour she says she underestimated.
I don't think I thought about it.
Well, you would have said no.
You're right. I think if I'd known fully the massiveness of it, the expectations of it, probably I wouldn't have. But I did, and it's been incredible.
These costumes tell as much of a story of the evolution of the characters as the series itself. For instance, Diana from this Liberty print she wore when she was a teenager working in a kindergarten, when she first started dating Prince Charles, all the way through the tumultuous events that led to her wearing her most famous outfit of all.
Putting on a defiant display in what many are already calling her revenge dress.
With so many of Diana's pieces, particularly in that era of her life, being seared into people's memories, including, of course, the magnificent revenge dress, how did you tackle that?
This is what you're given, not what you see, but our research pictures. How do you go about that, you know? It's a fine balance, and also you're making it for Elizabeth, who is incredibly beautiful, tall and sylph-like. So the proportions have to be for Elizabeth, not exactly like Diana, who was a very gym-toned, strong woman, that very fashionable then. So you're accommodating the beauty of Elizabeth, the Bicky, who looks just so stunning.
Every house has rules. Places like this are all about what you wear and when.
Gillian Anderson as Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher. Mrs. Thatcher had such a distinctive style. How did you capture it, work with it for Gillian to wear? What was going through? This is one of the pieces you designed.
That's here. An iconic piece. There's a visual journey where she's slightly more frumpy, mumsy to begin with. And as her power increases, she realises the power of being a woman in that top job. Whether you like her politics or not, pretty unique person.
It's sort of tough and soft.
It's a real mixture, isn't it, with that bow. It's quite interesting kind of vibe, isn't it?
So what happens to it all now? Well, 450 items are going to go to auction, including the famed revenge dress. Proceeds will go to the Crown Scholarship Fund at the London Film and Television School, benefiting the next generation of great British actors.
What happens to them otherwise? They just end up on racks and get dusty, and they've got another life, a life that's going on. I love it.